Oh, hello. What are you doing here? How are you doing? All right, we're down by the river and I've got the board down here and I'm gonna be doing a 44 volt test. I upgraded my connections for the big connectors and I only had enough to do either the parallel or the series. So I went with the series and we're gonna try the 44 volts out now just to see what's going on. So it should be quite good, you know. I'm gonna get the head cam on as well. I've got my other camera now you're looking at. A few bugs knocking about, yeah. Let's get this head cam on. Okay, got the controller. Turn that on, unlock. Getting a bit more used to the process now, guys, you know. Takes a minute, doesn't it, get into it. So I'm connected up in series. Now you should be able to see these jets as well firing a little bit better. Now we're gonna plug in the second one of these. Okay, we're spinning. Got the amps going here, upside down. Let that matter. Okay, I've got a steady arm here. Oh, okay, she's pokey, guys, she's pokey. I could do a way of seeing this the right way around. I'm just about to see that, I think. Okay. Amps there. It's definitely got some kick now, people. Hey. Alright, that's nowhere near full yet. We've got water flow, batteries are nice. Crikey, I say, hey. Eh? 120 amps there, nearly. 119 was their actual number, but any more. Got up to 140 there, guys. Whew! You like my spot? Look, there it is, goes all the way down there. And then all the way up there. But it gets shallow here in the middle. Let's try again here. So I've got no water infiltration, looks like. It's pretty good. Oh, it's just so twitchy on that throttle. Hit a 162 there, I think. Yeah, now I've got an engine beeping at me. I think we had a high amp cut there. Well, let's see what's happened here. That spiked up to 162. All right. Okay, yeah, these wires at the back of the motors are fairly warm. Let's just make sure, we'll let that cool down just for a couple of seconds. Let's make sure I haven't blown up the motors here. There should be a cutoff if there's a, it should be a safety thing, surely. Okay, that's back. Okay, so we went above the amps there, which is a little bit of a, okay. I can't really go any more than 150 amp on them engines. Yeah, these wires at the motor wires here, definitely a little bit wham. The motors themselves, they're nice and cool all round really. I wonder if that's why, yeah, is that what makes them rated at 150 amp, you know? It's another question, isn't it? Some more questions than answers you get building these things. Let's do one more for you, all right? I can't get a good foot in here, guys. That was 150 there, and I'm still not full throttle. Okay, I think we're good there for a minute. I don't want to blow anything up. There's a touch of water coming in from somewhere though. Again. Hey, here we are, look. Lovely jubbly. Right, take this bloody head cam off a minute and I'll be with you. Okay guys, so that's 44 volts, but it's actually more. It reads out at about 50 volts nearly fully charged, which is crazy. But yeah, I had a couple of comments, one for the wire size, and that I have changed now. Everything's running on 8 aug wire, so that's good. The wires feel great, but I hit over 150 amps there. I saw it go to 160 and the engine's cut. So I'm guessing I can't go above the 150. That might be a bit of an issue, guys. At the end of the day, I'm not really sure. I might have to change the pitch of the prop. That was another comment. And that could be in the cards to bring the amps down. Maybe putting some capacitor banks before the ESCs. Someone else suggested. I also saw the guy do it on the Youngsters Jet channel. He gave me the idea, in fact. You know, I looked at him first and thought, well, if he can do it, then I'm gonna have a go. So I did. And this is 40 odd volts now, tested. 22 was definitely probably a bit under. I'm not sure. I mean, I thought up in the voltage brings the amps down. Now, I could be wrong. Maybe it didn't. Maybe I just didn't ever hit full power on 22 volts either. That's kind of, or do I go for some 4S lipos and go for 14.8 volts, you know, times two, which will give me the 30, some, you know, 8 cell, basically. There's lots to be sort of played with and knowledge to be had. I'm not really 100%. I've just limited out the motor. So hopefully you could see the jet there was, it was pushing, you know, it was tidy. but yeah, it's hard to hold on to, so it's kind of one of them. Is the force of me holding the board also gonna obviously make the amps go higher than they need? Once I'm actually going along, they shouldn't go as high, but I feel like there's more to be done, guys. Yeah, if those motors cut at a certain amps, then obviously I could probably still have a go riding, you know. I'm not going to blow the ESCs, they're 300 amp, I feel. They're probably okay. And everything else was cool. So, we'll see. I'll be back with more, guys. You stick with me. Hit them buttons. Thanks for all the subs and comments. Lovely jubbly. Love all that. And I'll see you on the next one, guys. Take care. Bye.